What's going on, everyone? Back here with another video today, and today we're going to be talking about a video that was made a few weeks ago about a truck that was purchased by a popular YouTuber by the name of TJ Hunt. TJ is a very popular YouTuber, automotive enthusiast, and picked up a really sick truck. And I want to just make a video because he made a little note in there about letting him know what he should go with in terms of setup. So I'm going to give my 2 cents here because I have built a few trucks in my life and I do feel like I have a little bit of experience in that department. That being said, let's go ahead and hop right into it. But before we get too much further along, I really do want to say thank you to all the recently new subscribers, all the people that have joined us here on Intense Industries. Really do appreciate it, and I want to say thank you so much. That being said, this truck is sick and it appears to be a very optioned out truck. It has all the amenities, it appears, and it is one of the latest models from GM, specifically the Chevy 2500. It is outfitted with a 6.6 liter Duramax L5P, and the thing is nasty if you are a truck person. I myself am, and I think this truck is absolutely amazing as it is right now, but it can always be personalized and made to have that little extra touch of personal tweaking. So when it comes to these trucks, there are some certain things that you need to know, whether you are a truck person or you aren't a truck person. Chevrolet throughout the years has put the independent front suspension in their trucks, and for the 2500, 3500 models, they do have what's called a torsion bar setup. This provides the suspension and resistance, therefore, on the front end. Some front ends have leaf springs, others have coil springs, but these have torsion springs. And basically, that setup is a long bar that is attached about the middle of the vehicle up to the lower control arm, and this provides the suspension and all of that. That being said, it can be a little difficult to, not difficult, but it kind of limits you on how you can lift these or level these. And most people will automatically go for the leveling kit. I think that's what TJ mentioned he did before. But I would like to persuade in another direction, and that would be going with the suspension lift or a coil over conversion. The suspension lift that I would go with would be the 4-inch Cognito Motorsports kit. I think that kit is great and a superior option for this truck. It offers enough lift to put a tire on there and level out the front end, giving it a nice setting, if you could say, you know. And the other option is which is an option that I really want to do myself is the coilover conversion. Having had these GM trucks with the torsion bar setup, I know the pains and frustration of dealing with that, and I would really like to give this coilover setup a try myself, but I really think TJ, having dealt with coilovers plenty in his adventures with his cars, I think that he would really enjoy this setup, and I really think that the ride would be great. I look forward to, you know, seeing more about these kits in the future. I have seen a few so far, but I think TJ doing this on his truck, I think it'd be a really great option. That being said, I think that there would be, you know, some other tweaks and stuff in terms of shocks and maybe some powder coat to these components. I think those would be really cool. Again, the suspension lift that I would recommend would be from Cognito Motorsports, and the coilover conversion kit that I would recommend was from BDS Suspension. Moving on to the tires and wheels, the tires that I recommend, and I've placed and I've built so many trucks throughout the years that I kind of have developed a favorite brand, if you might. You know, I do love all brands of tires. I think all of them have something unique and special about them. But whenever it comes to off-road, all-terrain, mud tires, all of that stuff, there are a few that I really do prefer. And the first one that I would say would be the Toyo All-Terrain. And that tire is just, is very unique to me. And I've had some really good experiences with Toyo throughout the years. And I really do like that tire for an all-terrain. But a tire that I think I would probably go with if I were TJ would be the Exo Grappler from Nitto. It is a great tire. It has that aggressive look without being too extreme, and I think it would fit this truck very nicely. I would probably go with a 33-1250. I think that would be perfect, just because I know TJ probably will still tow with this truck, and I think that it will you know, give it an aggressive look without going too high. In terms of a wheel, I would stick with either a 20 or go to a 22. Both would be great options, and probably would stick with a 10 inch wide just for purposes of usability. And going too wide on these trucks, you kind of know how that goes with, you know, wearing out parts faster than, you know, we would like. But it's all part of it, about achieving that look that you want. So, you know, I would stick probably with a 10 inch, possibly a 12 inch if you can get the right offset, and that would be that. As for the wheels, I probably would stick with a forged wheel. I think they're great. I think they look amazing, especially the American Force Concave series. I think would look great on a truck like this. I'm really a big fan of the Concave series. I think it just offers a dimension for the wheel that, you know, it's not, I don't know, it's very unique, and I'm really liking it right now. As for wheel color, I would probably go with a black. I'm a big fan of black wheels or some type of wheel other than a polish. The polish, you know, they have a lot of upkeep, and I just think there's so many other options out there. Why not explore those options? That being said, it really rounds out the suspension and tire and wheel setup of the truck. You know, whenever it comes to trucks, there's so many different options you can do in terms of modification, from fender flares to bed stuff to, you know, bumpers and all of that. I definitely would explore the bumpers if I were him, just because I think they really add a unique look as well. But if that is to be explored at any point, I'll definitely make a video on that as well. TJ, if you're seeing this video, I really appreciate the time, and continue the content that you put out. I think it's great, and it's great to follow along. Great to watch, great to enjoy, and I think what you're doing out there is really neat. So that being said, thanks everyone for watching the video. Thank you for taking the time out of your day to enjoy the content. And for those of you that have not subscribed already, I would appreciate you hitting that subscribe button, hitting the like button, sharing a comment with me down below. Let me know what you might like to see in the future. That's it for this one, guys. Have a great day.